Hello students, so the third form we are going to see, that is su. Yeah, now here also you are going to one place to another, but here it is not a country, it is not a city. Yeah, here you are going to some place which is Gebäude, Raum or Ort. Gebäude means buildings. Raum means room. Whenever I tell you something, students, always try to note it down in your book. Ort means places. Now, this places, I don't mean to say like countries or cities. This places is like park. Park is also a place. It is not a building. It is not a room, but it's a place. Yeah. So, if you're going to such places, which is not a building, which is not a room, but still it is a place, it is not a country, it is not a city, yeah, that time you can use this zu word. Zu word can be used for Gebäude, Raum and Ort. Buildings, you can do some drawing over your building. Raum means a room and Ort means some places, which is not a country, but because if a country is there, then we have to use nak, which you have watched in the previous video, I hope. If you are using articles, then use in for TO2. Now here also the meaning is to, but this is a building. You're going to some building, you're going to some room, or you're going to some place which is not a city or a country or a state. Wohin gehst du? I'm asking this person, where are you going to go? Wohin gehst du? He is saying, ich gehe zu dem Kino. Now student, zu word. Though you can see a motion over here, I know, but su is very loyal to dative case. So though we are in the motion over here, we have to write an article with dative article only. Yeah, because su comes in dative prepositions actually. It is very loyal to dative case. You are writing su because you are going to that place, and that place is a building or a room or some particular place which is not a city or a country. So you're going to those places, but su is a dative itself. So we are writing dative article over here. You can make same sentences with the word fahren, reisen, and do send it to me. Make some 4 to 7 sentences if possible and do send it to me. Use different places which are buildings in German, like Kino, Schuler. There are many. Office in German, what it is called. Find it out. Make some sentences. Some rooms example you can give. Living rooms, bedroom, bathroom. You can use this example. So you're going to that place, and those places should be building, that is Gebäude, or Raum. Raum, building, Ort. Like this examples, you can give it to me. You're going to that place. Now in this video we are going to see zu. If you haven't watched the previous video, we are on number 4, so please do watch 1, 2, 3 and then come back to this video. Now as you know, zu is a dative preposition, very loyal to dative case, but in this context you are in the process of going. Here is a person, he's going somewhere. Now where is he going to go? Wohin gehst du? We are asking this person, wohin gehst du? Where are you going to go? He's saying, I am going to. Now, zu can also be used for personen, for people, the name of people, yeah, name of a person. Ich gehe zu. Now, that person can be a profession also, like here, Arzt means doctor, Mechaniker means mechanic. Now, for Arzt and Mechaniker, of course, we need to write an article, and it's a person also. So they are person. So zu can be used with person. If an article it has, write article. Now if names are given, like Peter, Sania, Mika, many other names are there. If you are writing some name of some person, then you don't have to write an article, because if you are learning German, you know with the names article doesn't come. So ich gehe zu Priyanka means I am going to Priyanka. Ich gehe zu dem Mechaniker. I am going to mechanic. Ich gehe zu dem Arzt. I am going to doctor. So zu can also be used for personen. Make few sentences. Do send it to me.